Welcome back to our class. In the previous class, we have started the poem Polonius Advice to His Son, written by William Shakespeare. William Shakespeare actually known for his all the plays, poems and writings. And as I said in the previous class, that he was not only the poet of his ages, but he belongs to our ages as well, and it continue to be in our future. So he has written this poem as a piece of advice of a father to his son, and the father was not an ordinary person. He was one of the counselor to King Claudius in the tragic poem, or you can say the tragic play Hamlet. So this chief counselor's son was going to France to study more in the university, and the father in the university means obviously the son has grown up. But still the father wants to give him some pieces of advice to make him realize that how to handle and how to remember the advices of the father and take care of the next steps in the future. And as I believe that children never grow up in such a way that they don't need the advices of the parents, they definitely need the advices at every corner, or you can say every stage of their life. Now here the poem starts with this: there. My blessings with thee. I have written the glossary over here. Thee means you. My blessings are with you. Now I am giving you my blessings. With and these few precepts in thy memory. Few precepts, rules for behavior, advices for behavior, how to think, what to, how to behave. I am giving you few precepts in thy memory, in your memory. That means I am advising you some rules of behavior with my blessings. See thou character, thou your character. Give thy thoughts no tongue. Here, this line is divided into two parts. One is here, with that you are getting one full stop. That means one advice and the second advice. Now one advice is see thou character, check your own character, your own personality, check yourself, see yourself whether you are going right or wrong. How to check ourselves? Simple. We have conscience, which is given by God to all of us, which tells us which is right and wrong. Conscience is the inner voice which makes us realize that this is right and this is wrong. If you are doing something wrong, definitely you get a sensation into your inner mind, inner heart, that you get a feeling that I am doing this work or this thing is wrong. I am doing this act in a wrong way, or this is not the right thing. You get it or not? Yes, everybody does. Because God has created us with a judge for our own self. So there is no need for the others to become the judge. We ourselves are the better judge. If we listen to our conscience, if we listen to our own thoughts. So what he is saying is that see thou character. First check yourself. Better to first check yourself rather than pinpointing on the others. First check your own self. Then give thy thoughts no tongue. Be quiet. Don't, whatever your thoughts, thy means your, whatever your thoughts are, don't give them tongue every time. Because what will happen? Maybe few people don't like your advice. Maybe few people don't like what you said. So it's better if you don't give your thoughts any tongue. Don't speak too much. Don't talk to the people more. Keep your thoughts to yourself. Because it is right actually that if our thinking or if our thoughts can be get public, we will get beaten up daily then. Because whatever we are thinking, it is up to us only. We cannot, thank goodness that nobody can able to listen our thoughts. Otherwise what will happen? Daily either somebody or the other, their relations will get completely damaged, or they may, the friendships will not continue, and the other relations also get into trouble if the thoughts would be listened by the other person. So it's better that whatever God has given us the capacity to think, but He has given us one tongue as well, and that tongue to be under your control, when to speak and what to speak, that you have to understand. This is only written as give thy thoughts no tongue, but the actual meaning is very deep. Like whenever you feel like that, whatever you feel like that, don't speak, don't utter in front of everybody. Sometimes you may have got into the situation that where you got a scolding from your mother or father, that she doesn't know when to talk, she has spoken so many things, like sometimes it happens. So do you realize that that was the wrong time, you have used the wrong words in front of the wrong persons? So these three things to be adjusted: right time, right people, and right words. If we don't understand whether the situation is right or wrong, better to keep quiet. So that's the same advice he is giving here, is that don't give your thoughts a tongue, don't speak out your thoughts, keep it within yourself. Nor any unproportioned thought his act, not any unproportioned act his thought. Unproportioned, not proper. Anything you know, this is not good, so don't do that. Unproportioned, which is not good, the thought you are getting itself is not good, so don't give it an act. Don't act on the thought which is not good for you. You know that this is not a good thought. Sometimes some people get provoked very easily. Provoked, the other person come to you and tell that so and so ABC or somebody was saying something against you. Immediately you want to go and have an argument, have a fight or something. Better to first identify the fact, first realize the fact, and then you can go further. I think in previous class also I said the same thing, that please don't act emotionally, don't respond immediately, don't give your reaction immediately. Think for a moment, and especially when you are getting angry, never give your reactions, because sometimes it becomes too late to rectify our mistakes. So it's better to keep our thoughts, and if we are getting something wrong in our mind, you know there is something wrong, so don't do the work, because you will get a continuous teasing of your conscience. That conscience will tease you that you have done something wrong. Continuously it will be in your back of mind, and you will not get the sleep properly. It's better to not to do that type of the act. If suppose you have seen one of your friend is doing something wrong, if you can't stop them from doing, don't accompany them for doing that one. Can't stop, okay, it's not in your hand. If you can try, that's better. If you cannot, don't accompany them, don't give them the company of doing anything wrong. He wanted to say the same thing. Be thou familiar, but by no means vulgar. When your thoughts, maybe if you have good thoughts, you can continue to do the act, you can perform that, but by no means go into any vulgar things. Vulgar, which are morally bad, morally not good things, are known as the vulgar things. So he is saying that don't become vulgar, don't leave your decency. There are certain levels of decency which we have to maintain. So he is saying that if you find something, some proper act is not there, some proper thought is not there, don't act. If you are familiar with anything, if you want to go and get involved into anything, do the work, but don't become vulgar, don't leave the decency mark. Sometimes it happens that, like when you are doing some work, any function, organization of any function, any program, any drama or play, when you are performing, you are doing the practice rehearsals before the actual performance, in those times sometimes it happens that you agree and disagree with your own members, team members. So when you are getting disagreed, okay, this is your right to get disagree. You are disagreeing, you have a point, valid point to disagree, go ahead. You are disagreeing is correct. But don't leave the limit of decency when you are disagreeing. Within the limits of decency, disagree. Don't start abusing the other person. Don't behave in such a way that all will go into vain. No, just you have to concentrate what you are doing, but in a better way, in a decent manner rather than a vulgar one. The next is, these friends thou hast and their adoption tried. The friends you have, whatever your friends are, you have the friends, hast and thou, I have written the meaning, hast, have and thou, your. So your friends, whatever your friends, you have your friends with you. Those friends you have, their adoption tried. That means you know their habits. Since long you are the friends and you know that they are faithful, they never do backbiting against you, they never cheat you, they never talk anything ill about you. These type of the friends, if you have, then you are the luckiest one. Seriously, because if we need the friends who, you have to be the same type of friend then. We cannot only want it that I need a good friend. You have to become a good friend to get a good friend. That is a reciprocal, give and take. So if you have that type of the friend, the father is advising, if you have this type of the friend who takes care of you, who has, like you can trust and rely on that friend, then what you have to do? Grapple them to thy soul. Grapple, to firm hold, to hold them firmly to thy soul. Tie them with your soul. Be always with them and don't let them go away. With hoops of steel. With hoops of steel means, hoops is the large rings. With the hoops of steel, tie their friendship to your soul. That means be always a good friend, or you can say the best friend though, for those people who have befriended for you, with you during the bad times and the good times, who always being there for you when you are in trouble, when you are in depression, when you are in poverty and in your rich times. Whenever you need them, they are with you. When you have tried their adoption, that means they are adaptable to you. They are always there for you. So don't let them go. At any cost, grapple them, hold them firmly to your soul. Don't lose that type of the friend. It is being said that if you have a good friend, if the friend is getting upset by you continuously, twice, thrice, fourth, how many times the friend is getting upset, try to rectify your mistakes and get the friend back once again. You go to the friend, ask forgiveness, apology, and just pamper the friend a lot, but get back that friend, because you cannot get the gems every day. These are the real gems. When if you find good friends, keep with us for a long time. They are going to be with us for a long time, and you have to be the same type of the friend in for themselves. So these are the few piece of advice given by Polonius to his son. First he said that I am giving you my blessings as well as some rules for the behavior, how to behave. The next he said that first check your character and don't give your thoughts the tongue. Don't speak out everything. And if suppose your thoughts are not good, don't act. Don't act on those thoughts. Don't implement those thoughts, whatever you are getting. And if the thoughts are good, do the work, but don't become indecent. Don't become vulgar. And if you have the best friends, those who are with you at every time, in every stage of your life, don't let them go. Grapple them, firm hold, have a firm hold on them, and continue to be with them till the lifetime. In the next class, we'll go ahead with the more stanzas of the poem. By the time, what you have to do is that, first of all, check it out the glossary, read the poem, underline the difficult words. Again, if you find any more difficult words for yourself, please underline those, write down the meanings in your readers. Maybe you have the textbooks with you. If you don't have, please get the textbooks immediately, because you can buy it from outside, and underline those words and write down the meanings with the pencils. There is a need for you to remember each and every meaning and the understand the proper meaning of your whole stanzas. Why I'm writing all these and giving you extra glossary? Because I want you to understand it, the exact message given by the poet, and try to keep it in your mind. And as I said in every class, that please, if you can able to go ahead, write down the summary of the stanzas, whatever we have explained in each classes. For every class, you can write down one para. Like this can be come into two lines, you can take two lines, or these two lines are important. You can go with this two lines. This itself has a two different meanings. Go for that one. The explanation is completed. You can rewind and see the explanation again and again, but try to write down in your own words the para related to the interpretation of the stanza. Next, in the next class, we'll try to complete the poem, or we'll go ahead with the next further stanzas of the poem. By the time, take care. Have a good day.